Chamath Palihapitiya announcing here on Halftime his latest special acquisition company will merge with the popular fintech firm SoFi.
I'm going to throw it right back at Joe, Scott. SoFi. Joe, you'll love this. SoFi calls, the weekly calls, 18 calls, boom, 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 bought. I'm in those.
The concept of online lending has been kind of a tough business lately. Many of the companies have been forced to scale back. But there's one privately held company that seems to be doing it right and then some. I'm talking about SoFi.
We've obviously been following SoFi for a long time. It's been a member of CNBC's Disruptor 50 list.
Yeah, you know, a lot of the things that I do is try to look back at some of the best investments we've made, like Amazon and Tesla, and try to find patterns. Yeah, in fact, you know, the way that I think about this is I call this sort of the anatomy of innovation, right? You look under the hood of the best companies and the best CEOs, they do the following things. The first thing is, look, I think you're seeing, even through the events of the last 24 hours, leadership and character really matter because you are faced with incredibly difficult decisions of policy, of morality. Yeah, you know, a lot of the things that I do is try to look back at some of the best investments we've made, like Amazon and Tesla, and try to find patterns. And in this, what I was trying to do was map those patterns into financial services, just because we're at a point in time where it's clear that the banking infrastructure really isn't meeting the needs of U.S. consumers. And so what I did was just kind of systematically try to figure out what was broken in banking, and then try to figure out which company was best representative of the solution that people wanted, which I can basically tell you is three things. People want low to no fees, they want fair and transparent lending, and they want a full suite of products so that you can basically have a one-stop shop. And SoFi basically was the top of the list when I looked across all the companies on those dimensions.
The legacy banking industry is one of the largest opportunities in the entire stock market. This is market share that has not been disrupted in over 100 years. These guys have literally mopped the floor with any competitors and continue to grow stronger and stronger at a steady rate because there's no competition. Square is basically the only fintech to put the pressure on these big banks. You have to understand there's a $2 trillion opportunity still up for grabs. 500 million people, 500 million accounts with opportunity to gain market share. Imagine a one-stop shop platform that can handle all of your needs from the process of your cell phone. You are able to do and get your money right by saving, spending, earning, borrowing. The list goes on. This is a one-stop shop platform offering, you know, stock market investing, insurance, mortgages. The list goes on.
Yeah, in fact, you know, the way that I think about this is I call this sort of the anatomy of innovation, right? You look under the hood of the best companies and the best CEOs, they do the following things. The first thing is, when you get a good product, you don't sit on your heels. You double down and you invest really aggressively to use technology to drive down the cost. And then what you do is you deliver those savings onto consumers. Then you launch many more products on top of the same platform. And the most important thing you have to do for people is to democratize access to a key resource. That's what Amazon has done. That's what SoFi is doing. Because the problem that banks have right now is after the great financial crisis, what they've done is they make money with hidden fees, with exorbitant fees. They have very restrictive lending practices. Ask anybody who's a middle-income person or a minority or a woman. It's incredibly hard to get access to the money you need to fulfill your dreams. And SoFi has fixed all these things, which is why I think it's such an incredible business.
So SoFi is a one-stop shop for consumer personal financial needs. We, on a mobile platform, offer you products to help you save better, spend better, borrow better, protect and invest better, which basically means we offer in-school loans, personal loans, which are unsecured, term loans with fixed rates and variable rates, We offer home loans. In addition to that, we refinance student loans. So if you went to college and funded your college via federal student loans and the government gave you like an 8% interest rate, they give everyone a flat rate and your credit score is strong and you deserve a better rate than 8%, we'll refinance at a lower rate, like 4 or 5%. In addition to that, we offer SoFi Invest, which is the ability to buy single stocks for no commissions. We also offer fractional shares, which we pioneered. In addition to that, we created SoFi Robo accounts, which are automated accounts that you can invest in. And it's a collection of different ETFs against a specific investment style, conservative, aggressive growth, et cetera. And then we also offer cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, Ethereum, Litecoin, and 16 other coins on the platform for Invest. In addition to that, we have a product called SoFi Money, which is it's like a checking savings account, although it's not a checking or savings account. You get a debit card, you can pay your bills with the debit card or ACH. You can pay with your phone at retail or online. We have no restrictions on your cash. We charge no fees. And we also give you free overdraft protection. We have features like Roundup when you spend, and we'll take the Roundup and put it into a vault for you, which is like a savings account. In addition to that, we also can create auto savings. We recently launched SoFi Credit Card. It's positioned as the only credit card to help you get out of debt as opposed to get into debt.
They're offering maximum perks if you sign up for the SoFi app. This is gonna allow them to gather massive data analytics for the customers for the years to come, offering a one-stop shop platform once again with thousands and thousands of product variations and massive cross-buying exposure once they get these customers into their ecosystem. This is the massive marketing tool that SoFi needs to dominate the banking industry and disrupt that $2 trillion opportunity with 500 million accounts up for grabs. The company is on track to exceed 3 million members by the end of 2021. According to their last earnings report, members have accelerated past 2.5 million members at the midway point through the year. This is massive, massive growth in an early stage growth stock. Revenue growth continues to accelerate, as we can see here. Revenue projection of $980 million for 2021 is expected to accelerate another 53% into 2022.
So, you know, the thing that Anthony has done, which is incredible, is he's basically created, again, as I said, this one-stop shop that gets, you know, your money right? A whole suite of products. And the thing is, a lot of what I've done in the past and what my team has done is really help people operationally improve how they grow, how they market, how they can virally expand. And all of these dynamics, I think, came to play because when you look under the hood at SoFi, there's this incredible thing happening. You have these millions of customers, 1.8 million last year, 3 million members this year, but then they are paying for millions and millions of products. And so what we saw were these dynamics where there was this incredible upselling and cross-selling behavior. And what I talked to Anthony about was, you know, can I help? Can I try to do what I've, you know, been able to do at Facebook, what I was able to do at Slack? You know, in fact, when Anthony and I first met 10 years ago, it was actually when he was at Twitter and we talked about working together there to do the same things. And so that's how the relationship started. And that's how we decided to come together and do this transaction.